Hello everyone, Ginshaw here. Today I'm starting a new series because it's October. So, yeah. This is System Shock 2. It's considered a cult classic. Look at the bottom, 1999. It came out August 11th, at least according to Steam, which is where I got it, because there was another company. Basically, it was made for, I think it was the PlayStation Classic, because I don't think the PlayStation 2 was even a thing yet. And then a company got the rights and ported it over to computer, and so it was already cult classic famous. It's a cult classic for horror FPS RPG, which, so yeah. By the way, before we get started with the game, it is rated M for mature, so take that as you will. You know, 17 plus rating, so just letting you know now. It's also horror, so if I swear during the video, I'm sorry, but it's a horror game, so it might happen. I don't know. We're gonna see. Anyways, I'm really excited just because I want to play it. It's October, which means Halloween and horror games and stuff, so this is the one I decided to do. We're doing webcam and everything, and it's gonna be good. It's gonna be good. So, let's get started. We're gonna see how these go. I don't really have editing software because the new computer, I'm gonna put that video up at some point. So I'm playing it on the new computer, so that should be... See, I've never played this game because I was not even one yet when this game came out, so I don't even know if I want to play normal because it could end up being like stupid hard. Also because controls might be really weird. Because it's ported from the PlayStation Classic. So, you know what? We're gonna go for normal and see how that goes.
Look at you, hacker. A pathetic creature of meat and bone, panting and sweating as you run through my corridors. How can you challenge a perfect immortal machine?
Is the one that got the right and put it over. I could be. I'll eventually figure it out. Correct myself, but
in 2072. A rogue artificial intelligence, known as Shodan, lost her mind. In her limitless imagination, Shodan saw herself as a goddess, destined to inherit the Earth. That image was snuffed out by the hacker who created her.
42 years. Why are you still using software 42 years ago? You'll see.
February 3rd is the day the magic happens. The Von Braun, AI, the first starship in history capable of traveling at faster than light speed, will undertake her maiden voyage. This incredible journey is the result of teamwork between the UNN Protectorate and the incredible scientific minds of the newly relicensed Trioptimum Corporation.
Imagine
being able to travel to distant star systems in a period of weeks.
Right,
it's all part of TRIOP's commitment to the future. The Von Braun is packed with over 1.8 billion flight, scientific, and security systems, nearly all developed by TRIOptimum and its wholly owned subsidiaries. Providing security for the Von Braun as she plows through the heavens will be the UNM Rickenbacker. At her helm will be no less than Captain William Bedford Diego himself, hero of the Battle of Boston Harbor during the Eastern States Police Action. This incredible union of government and corporation is made possible by an intricate series of docking mechanisms that will allow the Rickenbacker to piggyback its way into jump space.
That's like the only thing that's still expensive.
Revolutionary. Who knows what wonders await our crews in the bosom of the cosmos?
I mean,
all we do know is that it's a great day for mankind.
You wouldn't use software, so music, because then I'm going to have to start this over. If it gets caught in the audio, because I'm going to have to check everything. And Oh, good. I was legitimately worried that I wouldn't be able to look around and would have to, like, figure out, like, some awkward thing with my right hand on the keypads. Okay.
Welcome to the Ramsey Center UNN Recruitment Facility. Please watch your step when leaving the train. The grav shafts at the end of the hall will take you to the street-level training and recruitment center. Please proceed to the grav shafts.
Don't know where that is. Okay. Who? Why? Come on, people. You don't spill stuff. Janitor, clean up on aisle 2. Hey guys! Guys! Wow, not even gonna look. Like... Oh my gosh, you moved. It's just... Okay, where did they say to go? I'm guessing I need to go up this thing.
Step into the grav shafts to proceed to the street level recruitment.
Okay. Oh, there it is. Okay. Oh! I just needed to turn around because I'm not being smart right now, apparently. Okay. Where do I go? Again with the spilling of things and knocked over trash cans. Clean up on aisle street level training camp. I don't know. I'm trying to be funny, okay? It's a horror game. I'm nervous. That's the other thing that was making me nervous about doing this series, is I don't know how I'm gonna be playing this game, because I don't typically play a lot of horror games. And by that I mean I just don't play horror games, period. And the few times I've, like, tried to play them, it's just like...
Before you choose your career, you'll want to learn some basic abilities. First, you should go into the basic training center. When you're done with basic training, proceed to the advanced training area.
Oh good, they're gonna train me, so this is gonna be a lot of me figuring stuff out, because,
To pick up some basic skills you'll need to get by in the service, enter the... Welcome, trainee. While you're in our virtual training courses, we provide you with a simulated cyber interface. This training interface is identical to an actual military-grade cyber interface. Now, let's try it out. Move the mouse. See how it changes where you look? That means you're in shoot mode. Hit the tab key. This puts you in use mode, where you can use your mouse to interact with items in the world. Open your primary MFD, or multifunction display, by clicking on the MFD button near the bottom of the screen. This display shows your strengths in various areas. When you're ready to continue, press the tab key to go back to shoot mode. Try changing between modes until you get the hang of it. Follow the red path along the ground to the next training station.
Okay, I don't know. Endurance. Okay, I can get all of the cybernetic affinity. Improves your chance of successfully using it. Okay. I don't know what this is. Like, I know... I'm pretty sure I know what everything except for this is, because this is just hacking stuff. Because if you haven't got on, basically we're going to be fighting AI and all sorts of weird stuff. So it's going to be cool. It's also 1999, so... Oh no, there's more stats. Why are there so many stats? Okay, we're going to ignore that for now and just go.
To pick up items, center them on your screen and right-click. This will automatically place that item into your inventory. To view your inventory, press the tab key. You can move items around your inventory by left-clicking and dragging them around. To To drop an item, drag it from your inventory into the 3D view, and release the mouse button. To use items like buttons in computers, center them in your view, and click the right mouse button. All usable items will have brackets around them. Highlight the button on the pillar and right-click. This will activate the lift. Try it out. If you can still see your inventory display, it means your... The object before you is a med hypo. Pick it up and then press Tab to go into Use mode. Right-clicking on the med hypo will use it and see the crate in front of you? To search it, center it on your screen and right-click. If you are in Use mode, simply move the pointer to the crate and right-click. To take an item from that container, simply left-click on it. This will automatically place that item in your inventory. One of the most important tools you have as a soldier is your PDA. This device stores audio logs, emails, and other useful information. Click on the disk icon near the bottom of your screen to bring up the PDA display. Currently, the contents of your PDA are empty. Now, pick up the audio log in front of you. This message is coming from the audio log you just picked up. Oh, you can use your PDA at any time to play any audio log or email you've received. In the field, the PDA is also used for keeping track of your current mission objectives and obtaining help information.
Oh my gosh, I know they were a thing, but like, I can't remember. It's so weird,
Now it's time to learn about jumping and mantling. To jump, simply press the space bar.
I haven't even... You know, I'm
some surfaces can be mantled onto by holding down the space bar. Mantling lets you pull yourself up to ledges and other high places in front of you. Give it a try.
What? It turned itself invisible. Okay. What? Okay. Why does it not want me? Okay, you know what? I'm just gonna ignore that bit.
To climb a ladder, simply walk into it and look upward. You'll automatically start climbing the ladder.
That's not gonna be good if that happens. Oh my gosh.
You've done well. Remember, if you're unclear on any aspect of what you've just learned, you can repeat the training as often as you wish.
Okay, that'll be...
If you've completed basic training, you're ready for the advanced lessons provided here. Advanced training will familiarize you with the three key areas of military service: weapons training, technical training, and psionics training. Approach the Cyberlink booth of your choice to train in that area. When you finish training in the three areas, proceed directly to the recruitment.
All right, wannabe. If you want to learn the weapon skills it takes to even think about joining the Marines, come on in. We're looking for a few good men.
He just picks the most...
Good to have you on board. You'll notice when you're in the Cyberlink booth, the UNN has kindly provided you with a virtual cyber interface and all the simulated skill levels you'll need for the training tasks. Okay. But don't get too cocky. They'll disappear once you leave the booth.
Okay, well, that's...
Now we'll teach you how to handle a firearm. Pick up the pistol and the clip from the table. You can equip the weapon in one of two ways. Bring up your inventory and drag the pistol to your weapons equip slot near the right-hand side of your inventory. If that's too slow for you, you can use the hotkeys on the keyboard. Press 2. If the pistol was in your inventory, it will equip for you automatically. To lock and load the ammo clip, hit the R key or hit the reload button on the lower right corner of your screen. Once you've loaded the firearm, take a shot at the dummy robot by pressing your left mouse button when in shoot mode. Notice how its health bar gets shorter as you chip away at it.
Does it all do the same amount of damage? No, it does not. I don't think. It probably does. Okay. Follow the linear path.
Some items need to be charged with energy before they can be used. Pick up the laser pistol. Now use the recharging station nearby. The recharge station will juice up all of your energy-based items. Weapons, batteries, you name it.
I'm guessing I need to shoot the dummy. I love that explosion. It's just a PNG, like... It's so awkward. I love it.
Weapons are not fine wines. They do not get better with age. The colored dot on the lower right corner of the screen tells you what kind of shape your firearm is in. Green is good, red is bad. To fight the effects of wear and tear, a soldier with maintenance skill can use a maintenance tool to improve the condition of his weapon. Just pick up the tool, open your inventory, and drag the tool onto your pistol. Remember that maintenance tools are only good for a single use.
Oh, I see. They left it damaged so that you can... Okay. Okay. That is very slow shooting. Oh, so it's like a GIF or GIF or whatever. There is animation to it. Oh my gosh, I misjudged this game.
Good work. Now you're ready for the Marines. Take a look at the other training areas first before you enlist. They might just come in handy.
Guy like ever for like.
Inside, we'll teach you the basics of some technical skills you'll need in the Navy.
That one wasn't too stereotypical,
welcome.
At least.
You'll notice when you're in the Cyberlink booth, we'll provide you with a temporary cyber interface and the skills you need to accomplish the training tasks. But they'll only last so long as you're in the booth.
Oh, that's the fire alarm. Okay, we're gonna end the episode and then... Okay. Okay, I'm back. I remembered that I could pause the episode instead of ending the recording and messing everything up, so... That was good.
The object in front of you is a container of nanites. Nanites are consumed whenever you perform technical tasks, such as hacking or repairing. When you pick up the container of nanites, they do not go in your general inventory, but are instead displayed in use mode on the bottom left of your screen. Walk over to the keypad by the door and try out hacking.
Okay.
Use the keypad by right-clicking on it. To the right of the number pad, you'll see an orange tab labeled Hack. Left-click on the tab. Text will appear indicating the difficulty of the hack and any bonuses that apply. Click on the Start button to begin hacking. You'll see a grid of nodes. Clicking on a node will either turn it bright or dark. To successfully hack, you must connect three bright nodes in a straight line. Beware the ice nodes with the red outlines. If one of these turns dark, you fail the hack, and you might break the item you're working on, or worse. You can restart your hack attempt at any time by hitting the reset button, though you'll have to pay the nanite cost again.
Okay.
You can use nanites to buy items from replicators. To use a replicator, right-click on it.
Hi there.
Then left-click on the item you wish to purchase. The item you purchased will drop into the slot below. Make sure you pick up your purchases before you leave.
Hi there. Please make your selection. Thank you for choosing value wrap.
You learn the basics of the technical skills. There are several other technical skills you'll learn throughout the course of your career, such as repairing items and modifying weapons. The cyber interfaces for these tasks are similar to the hacking interface. Before you enlist in the Navy, try out the other training courses. They'll be useful.
Okay. Oh, because there's three different...
Inside, you will learn how to reach out with your mind. Do not let fear block your path.
What accent is that? Like, at first I thought it was Southern, now I'm like, wait, no...
We've provided you with a virtual interface and the temporary ability to project simulated psionic powers. Once you leave this area, these powers will be lost to you.
Okay.
The red bar at the lower left of your screen tells you how many psi points you have.
I have no
psi points symbolize the current ability to use your psi powers. Psi hypos replenish your psi points. Try using a psi hypo and watch your psi points increase. When you've reached your maximum in psi points, move to the next station.
I'm being stupid. It was over here. I was being dumb. Okay.
This psi amp amplifies your psi powers and lets you project them into the real world. To equip it, pick it up, and then hit the tilde key. Firing the psi amp activates your currently selected psi discipline. You currently have access to two disciplines, cryokinesis and kinetic redirection. Go into use mode and click on the arrows on the bottom right of the screen. This will cycle through your available psi disciplines. Later, clicking on the arrows above the number to the left will allow you to select psi disciplines from higher tiers. Use cryokinesis to destroy the robot and kinetic redirection to pull that nanite container towards you. Be careful. Holding down the mouse button can augment the power, but holding it down for too long will cause burnout, which will damage you. If you run out of psi points, use another psi hypo.
Okay. That is... the needle in the arm, though. And the arm is just so awkward. Again, with the awkward-looking things, because it's not HD.
Mastery of the mind is a slow but rewarding process. Return to this area if you need more guidance.
Again, which branch
before you enlist in the OSA, it would be useful to experiment in the other training courses.
That's got to be some sort of special branch. So, now the decision is Marines, Navy, or OSA. Let's see. Well, I do have a cousin that was in the Navy, and I have a friend that went into the Marines recently, so...
Here's where you make your choice, soldier. Here's where you enlist in one of the three branches of the military. Once you decide on your branch of service, there's no going back. A shuttle will take you to a UNN orbital space station, where you'll receive a briefing regarding your yearly postings. Good luck.
See, I don't know which one to do. I might end up having to do three different playthroughs of this. We're gonna see. how it goes. If this game ends up being shorter, I might end up doing 3 playthroughs and doing one of each. This one's Space Shuttle 1, 2, or 3. You know what? I feel like this one would be interesting. I think this one's gonna take a while because of all the hacking stuff. And this one's gonna be more like a first-person shooter. But they're probably all gonna have shooter stuff. Just this one's probably gonna have more of it. This might be interesting. Decisions. Let's see. The psychic stuff is pretty dang cool. But at the same time, I'm probably not gonna do Navy right now, because the hacking stuff's probably just gonna be slow. I'm debating Marines or OSA. I'm gonna do OSA. Seems like a good way to do it. Just seems the most interesting. Again, I have no idea what branch the OSA is. I'm gonna end up having to look this up. Watch it be some made-up thing, too. Like, honestly. What is this reading? 0.9 G's, okay. Okay, so that all is just normal. Okay. Environment pressure control. Environment gravity control. Environment temperature control. Okay. Mission proceed. Keep. Do not block. I'm blocking it with my body. What is... Oh, it's a person. I thought it was a robot. Okay. His face is just so... He's Phineas from Phineas and Ferb. He has the triangle nose. You guys don't know what that is. Okay, year one. Okay, I'm playing through this very slowly, I feel. Okay, that's not a button. This is a robot, for sure.
The OSA welcomes you to Orbital Station Chun-Lo. Ready yourself to feel the limitations of your mind slipping away. We will guide your path over the next 4 years. The shuttle bays at the center of the station will ferry you to your next stage of growth. When you've chosen, head into the appropriate shuttle bay. Get ready to learn things you've never imagined.
Okay, again with non-responsive people. I think that's a lady? I can't tell. I'm guessing based on long hair that's a lady. Solely based on long hair. I think 1999, they were probably thinking that the mullet was going to be gone. So... Okay, that door won't open. Will this one open? Nope. This is another link, I think. No, I think that's a dude. I don't know. It's hard to tell in this game, which is weird. Everyone is made of cubes and triangles. Okay, so that one opened. Okay. So Sensory Deprivation Tank. TOS Chulun, I think. TOS Runong Sensory Deprivation. Shaoling. I can read that one. And not, I think. I'm probably still butchering it somehow. You know what? Yeah. Yeah, it's sensory Okay, so they're all sensory deprivation tanks. Great. We're gonna do this one.
The sensory deprivation tanks aboard the TOS Chulun are modulated for your training. You shall spend a year in contemplation of mass, both yours and that of objects, until you can bend them to your intentions.
A year in sensory deprivation. That's... Oh, that would be weird. That would be so weird. Oh my gosh. I can't just, like, I haven't done that, like, sensory deprivation stuff, so... Your year in the tank of Chulun is finished. Your will has grown. You can feel it gather to strike. You have learned how to freeze your foes in their tracks and how to shield yourself from them as well. Second tier disciplines are now within your grasp. You may now take your skills into the field to pit them against our enemies. If Master Tier 2 PSI disciplines Crown, Isis, and Cryo, and Ico Reflective Screen. Okay. It's gonna be. Oh, so it's. Also, I'm running because there isn't a button for walking right now, like a sign for it, so... Oh, I didn't realize that was going to be the... That was a... gosh darn, that was an actual decision. Interrogation. Research lab. We're doing psionic training.
Your body has been neglected in your training of your mind. On Io, you will find soldiers who wish to test their endurance. You will surpass their physical prowess without compromising your mental discipline.
What are these cutscenes? You are directed to return to Station 74-34A, or here the IO facility has reached its conclusion. You know that the only real opponent is one who is more cunning than you. You use the cadets around you as prey and learn from their failings. You sense the struggle has greatly enhanced your physical prowess. Okay. Okay. We're doing this one because...
Acts of political terrorism and corporate coercion disturb corporate and political stability. You shall spend a year battling these chaotic elements, both psionically and by physical force.
Okay, let's do it. Why not? Because current events... Kind of. Not really, which is good. But at the same time, yeah. Yeah. Wow. Actually seeing the future. February 2114. Thank you. Okay. Also, the alignment of, like, my stuff is all weird. That was three. What the?
You have clearance for landing on the Von Braun and
get
shuttle
your
bay
numbers
two.
Straight.
Welcome aboard, soldier.
Seriously, what the heck? 5 months later, UNN Von Braun. So is this me, or is this someone?
Steady yourself, soldier. This is Dr. Janice Polito of the computer ops staff of the Von Braun. You're safe for the time being. You're recovering from the effects of surgery and will be unable to remember any of the events of the last few weeks. You're on board the starship Von Braun, and
well,
something's gone very, very
that's
wrong.
Fun.
Some kind of force has hijacked this ship. That's why you volunteered to be implanted with some experimental cybernetic implants. Rely on your cyber interface. It just might save your life. You must find an elevator and come up to deck 4 to meet me.
Look at that nose.
Deck 4. Can you remember that?
Turn your head.
But keep
your
eyes
open.
They're after us both now.
Oh my gosh. Like... Oh my gosh. It's so... These graphics are...
Watch out. I'm getting strange readings from that radar dish outside the window. It's become unstable due to... Move! Take cover!
That's a dead guy.
Critical decompression hazard in the cryo recovery suite. Evacuate immediately.
Oh no, I can't... Oh, if I get a running start. Come on! No! Okay, we're going this way. We're going the sketchy way. Oh, we have to search the corpse. I want to take the corpse. Oh no, this thing's what I want. Like, seriously. Why would I want to use the wrench? Well, if I need the wrench, I know how to equip it. But... Oh, shoot. Okay, so I need to... Okay. No! Well, that would have been nice to know. Okay, we're gonna straight away just equip the actual long-range weapon.
The entire sector is depressurizing and the blue vacuum shield won't last long. Get through a secure airlock before you're sucked into space. Move it!
Warning. Decompression event imminent. Please move immediately to cryo recovery B. Decompression event imminent.
Okay. I am nervous now, because I just... zombie. All I have is this thing, and I just wasted ammo. Oh good, I have a bigger wrench. So I have...
This power cell is dead. There should be a recharger nearby. Just use it and it will recharge all the power-driven devices in your possession. After you've recharged the cell, plug it into the auxiliary power unit. That should open the airlock door. Be quick about it. The vacuum seals won't hold up much longer.
Airlock door inoperative. Auxiliary power override failure. Please replace power cell.
Before the whole area depressurized. I've just uploaded you some cybernetic modules. You can use them to upgrade your cybernetic rig at the upgrade units in this area. There are four types of units in the next room, one for each subsystem of your cybernetic gear. Stats, psi, weapons, and tech. But use the modules carefully. They're hard to come by.
I don't have much. Okay, this one's probably the safe one. weapon. That's a dead person. Steal their stuff. I keep hitting the Q button. Tech upgrade. Okay, so I should probably upgrade the one weapon I have. Oh, do I have to get all of these? This might be helpful. Okay. Why do I keep doing that? Okay. Oh, I can't even afford these. Okay. Can't afford those either. Great. Can't afford those either. I already checked that person. This door's broken. That's where I came from. The only way is to do... Oh, shoot. I am nervous. I'm gonna go that way. If anything moves, it's getting shot. Like... Infectious biohazard. That's nice. Wear protective clothes. Yeah, not doing that either. What was that? I actually jumped. Okay. Shoot. I'm so nervous because I know that there's the Zambos. I want that stuff. Okay. Oh, shoot. What is this? Okay. Oh, I'm so nervous. That is where the Zambo was. not going down to the Zambon.
Can somebody let me out? I can't find my card. Please, let me out of here.
What? Was that? Why am I so scared? Well, okay. I have an itch. Okay.
Well done. I'm uploading some more modules.
Come back. Did I forget to save?
Watch out. I'm getting strange readings from that radar dish outside the window. It's become unstable due to... Move! Take cover!
Decompression hazard in the cryo recovery suite. Evacuate immediately.
Okay, no.
The entire sector is depressurizing and the blue vacuum shield won't last long. Get through a secure airlock before you're sucked into space. Move it!
Access codes out of cryo A again. Like I've got nothing better to do. I think Grassy just likes to make work for me. I'll set the new code to 45100. That should be easy enough to remember.
Warning. Decompression event imminent. Please move immediately to cryo recovery B. Decompression event imminent.
I get the feeling.
This power cell is dead. There should be a recharger nearby. Just use it and it will recharge all the power-driven devices in your possession. After you've recharged the cell, plug it into the auxiliary power unit. That should open the airlock door. Be quick about it. The vacuum seals won't hold up much longer. Good. You've managed to get out before the whole area depressurized. I've just uploaded you some cybernetic modules. You can use them to upgrade your cybernetic rig at the upgrade units in this area. There are four types of units in the next room. One for each subsystem of your cybernetic gear. Stats, psi, weapons, and tech. But use the modules carefully. They're hard to come by.
Also, I have no idea how long I've been recording for, because I forgot to set a thing to tell me. So... that's pretty interesting. Okay.
Well, can somebody let me out?
I'll have to do it.
I can't find my car.
I'm
Please.
Guessing those are the lock.
Let me out of here.
Guessing. Okay. So, Zambo's next. Okay.
Access needed. Access needed.
Where's the access? Okay, zombie things. 3, 2, 1, flash. So there's one there.
Well done. I'm uploading some more modules.
Jeez, why was he so fast that time? Like, comment, subscribe. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I guess I'll see you in the next one, hopefully tomorrow. We'll see how the uploading and all that goes. Okay. Thanks. Bye. This is Skinshaw signing out.